So in this section of the video, I am going to be talking about the effects wax can have on snowboarding and friction while snowboarding. Is friction in snowboarding allows one to carve and maneuver as well as stop. In physics, friction is the force resisting the movement of an object, which is usually caused by bumps or imperfections on a flat surface. So this can be caused by rocks or ice or anything like that, anything hard enough to hit the surface or make it veer from the way it was going. So today I have my shoe here, and as you can see, there are divots in the bottom of the shoe, which make it so my shoe won't slide, or at least it won't slide easily. Now, for snowboarding, if you are going snowboarding and the snow is hard packed and it didn't just snow and the snow had time to ice over or get hard, then you would want to wax your snowboard. And as I have my snowboard here, you take your wax and you would just rub it along here with an iron and it would melt into the snowboard. And as you can see, there are crevices and like lines right here, and that's from the rocks hitting it and just uneven snow. And what the wax does is it fills it in, so it's a nice slick surface, so you're able to slide on the snow. But if it is just snowed, it's powder. And the opposite thing will happen to your snowboard, actually. It will pick up all the snow and make it stick, and it just won't be fun. So I'm gonna show you an example of this using my shoes. So how I'm going to represent this is I have one shoe that has no wax on it, and one shoe that does. Now, this shoe, when I push it against the cardboard, it's pretty hard to get it to slide. And that's friction, that's force pushing against the force that I am using to push the shoe forward. So as you can see, it does not go forward easily. And this is the one without wax, and that's because there's all the grooves and the grip. Now, with my shoe that has wax, it slides very easily. And I could just go like that and it slides. And that's because all of the grip on the bottom, or the grooves, are full of wax, and it makes a slick surface. Good. That is how wax affects the friction of a snowboard.
Parts of the board. This is the toe edge. This is the flat and fastest side of the board. And this is your heel edge. I'm switching from my front edge to my back edge. Switching from edge to edge can slow down the speed of the board because it causes more friction against the snow. Also, when you turn, the edge of your board will be pushing against the snow, causing force and traction to slow your momentum. If the opposing edge catches too much snow, it could cause you to fall. Some slopes are steep. If you're a beginner rider, don't think of the mountain as just going straight down. Imagine drawing a line going side to side like a zigzag. This is the line you are going to aim to follow. At the end of the run, you'll be able to look back up at the mountain and see the S shape you've made. If you wanted to go faster, you would make smaller turns, almost tilts. This would give you more time on the flat part of your board and less time on the edges, resulting in your board facing straight down the mountain more often.